And I'd be writing them, then I'd be really frustrated. I wouldn't know what to do with them. So it's great. I feel like I'm getting the best of both worlds right now, in a way. It's hard physically doing both things and never having a break, but I've kind of become a workaholic, so I've adjusted to that. We've always had a real good following. On the West Coast, it was a lot larger, and the South and the East Coast, it was smaller, but it was no less enthusiastic. And I think it was just because we, I don't know, I think we kind of stood out as a separate entity. There was like contemporary music and rock music, and then there was Oingo Boingo, and people would just gravitate towards us. We would get the eclectic and the strange and the weird, and people like ourselves that had a lot of pent-up energy and didn't know what to do with it, which is why we started in 79 as a band.
Life's been so good to me. Has it been good to you? Has it been everything that you expected it to be? Was it as good for you as it was good for me? And was it everything it was all set up to be?
A few years ago, a lot of songs weren't heard in movies. You know, the soundtrack was mixed real low, etc., etc. Is that frustrating for a writer who might spend some time on a song, and when you see the film, it's like maybe you only hear 6 seconds of it, and then it's mixed below the
Oh, yeah, unless it's the opening credits or end credits, you're not going to hear much of a song in the film. That's why I don't do it very much.
It's showtime.
Does success give you energy? Because when you did Beetlejuice, the film could have gone either way.
Yeah, I think everybody expected Beetlejuice to be financially a failure, maybe like a cult type of a film. I never expected it to be successful. I don't think the director even expected it to be really successful. But there was just this wonderful spirit, not speaking facetiously, because everybody was pulling for the film. Everybody wanted it to do well, because Tim Burton's the kind of director that gives everybody great creative license, and everybody wants to see him succeed.
Do you have an ongoing relationship with Tim?
I guess so. I'm already slated to do Batman in the spring. Naturally, I'm looking forward to that. I think every film composer looks forward to those special relationships with the director, where they kind of read each other's mind and they know what to expect from each other. And it's kind of like that with Tim and I.
Don't kill me! Don't kill me! Don't kill me, man! What are you?
Danny Elfman is now so successful with his work on movie music that he's finding very little time for his other love, which is performing live with Boingo. In fact, in the last 6 months, they've only done 2 gigs. But Danny is not going to be lonely on the Batman score. Since talking with him, I found out that Prince may be contributing some original songs to the soundtrack. So for more details, stay tuned to this same Bat Station.